completed all of my homework to unlock 99. Oh, wait, my bad. Let me redo that. I completed all of Team Affinity to unlock 99 Nolan Ryan. Yes, I completely no-lifed Diamond Dynasty over the holiday weekend so I could get this grind done. One, because I want to get that Mookie Betts card soon. And two, I really want to play Starfield. And I didn't want this big grind looming over me. But yes, I did unlock 99 Nolan Ryan, and I gotta keep it 100% honest with you guys here. I really don't care about this card all that much. We just had this 99 Ryan Express eligible in Season 2 and Season 3, so to me, this really doesn't feel like anything new, even though he is definitely a better version of Nolan Ryan than the last one. I'll touch on that more when I get into the gameplay, but this is what he's looking like. So he'll be starting on a full Team Affinity 4 team build. Of course, I'm also gonna use this collection Charlie Blackman, as well as this collection Brandon Crawford. And the bullpen on this team is not great, but the Tom Henke captain boost really does help this bullpen a lot. As I search for a game, just a reminder, if you're heading to any baseball games in this last month of the regular season, use code COOGS on SeatGeek. You'll save $20 on your tickets. And check out Underdog Fantasy for all your daily fantasy sports needs. These are the pick'em entries I have for today's MLB games. And don't forget about the special Patrick Mahomes pick that's still eligible for the first game of the NFL season. Sign up on Underdog if you want to play. Use code COOGS. They'll match your first deposit all the way to $100. Let's see how Nolan Ryan does against Roy Halladay. Come on, Chuck Nasty, start things off. Oh, is that a fluke? Ah! I originally was not going to start Tim Salmon in this video, but I realized I needed to. I have to start Timmy. Let's go, Crawford. Brandon Crawford gets our first hit. Not really surprised there. I loved his set two card. Ooh. No, dude, I thought that was gonna come back in on the plate. No! All right, let's see if this Nolan Ryan card is worth the grind for 90 Team Affinity cards. Gonna go sinker low and in on two strikes here, and we're getting him looking. One, two, I'm gonna stay low and away to Bellinger with a four seam here. Nice swing. Timed up the fastball, put a good swing on it. Good at bat. Was that a... Where did that miss? Oh, it was low. I 100% thought that was in the zone. That was weird. There we go. We'll follow it up with a good pitch, though. Come on, Nolan. Gotta get out of this. Good pitch. Good change up away to Jock. Come on. Let's get Nolan Ryan a lead. Ooh, I want that pitch back. Oh, there it is. Joey Votto. He gave me that same splitter. I didn't miss it this time. 1-0 lead. All right, so earlier I said that I have more to talk about when it comes to this Nolan Ryan card and Team Affinity in general. And I kind of have a lot to say, so I'm sorry if this kind of turns into a rant or whatever. So yeah, fair warning, this actually does kind of turn into a pretty long rant about the game. If you don't really care what I have to say, just feel free to go to this timestamp. The gameplay picks up like it's a totally normal video of mine, so... just fair warning. But I have really kept an open mind with this new sets and seasons content model this year. This is something entirely new for MLB The Show. They've never done anything like this. It's the most radical change the mode has had since MLB 19, when they added featured programs and Team Affinity and the XP reward path. And I've really wanted to give the game a few seasons to kind of develop, to kind of see what SDS does with feedback, how the game changes season to season, how the game feels with the, you know, turnover of cards from season to season. That's a good pitch from Nolan. And now with this set four Team Affinity grind done, I feel like I have just a better idea on how I really feel about Diamond Dynasty as a whole this year. And, you know, quite frankly, it's not great. I think there's a world where this sets and seasons model really works. I think it is actually kind of a cool concept when you break it down and execute it well. The problem is, I don't think they've executed it that well. I'm gonna go to a fastball high and in here. Got him again, 103 up top. Because I kind of feel like Diamond Dynasty doesn't really know what it wants to be. Is that a home run for George Brett? Oh, that's dying at the track. George! Yeah, I kind of feel like Diamond Dynasty doesn't really know what it wants to be right now. Because you have this sets and seasons content model that encourages rotating lineups from season to season. It encourages different types of team building with captains and theme teams and all this type of stuff. But at the same time, you know, we're getting a lot of duplicate cards from season to season. Like, we just had the Ryan Express from season two. We just had, you know, the Brandon Crawford from season two. And I understand that now in season four, those cards aren't eligible for ranked season lineups. And now these new cards you can use for the rest of the year. I get that aspect of it, I do. But the problem is that you have to grind for these players again. And I know they're technically better, or, you know, they are different cards. Chuck? Is this one dying too? Damn. But the game just doesn't really feel fun when you're grinding for the same players over and over again. That's kind of why I really just don't care that much about this Nolan Ryan card. Yes, he's going to be solid, and I'll probably use him a good amount, but we just had him. If you're going to do the sets and seasons model, make some of these cards unavailable for a season or two. Make us miss them. So that way, when you add the card back into the game in a future season, we're excited again. Which is why I'm saying that Diamond Dynasty doesn't really seem like it knows what it wants to be, because you have the sets and seasons model that encourages the rotating lineups, but you're giving us the same players. What's the point of the sets and seasons model if we're just going to end up using the same core group of players on our team from season to season? Do you want us to rotate lineups around and use different types of cards and build teams in a certain way? Or do you just want us to use the players that we would normally use anyway? If it's that side, then what's the point of sets and seasons? I feel like the way they did it with Mike Trout was actually pretty good. You had Mike Trout's 99 World Baseball Classic card available day one of the game. He could be used all of set one and set two. And then when season three came out, he had to go away, or you had to sacrifice your one wild card spot to use him. Yes, there was that 97 Mike Trout. Oh, Willie Mays gotta make this play. Yeah, we're there. Yes, there was the 97 Mike Trout, but that's not 99 Trout. People aren't using that in place of the 99 unless it's like on a very specific Angels theme team. And then set 4 comes out and we get this new 99 Trout that is significantly better. And people have missed Mike Trout. People have wanted a new Mike Trout card for a season now. It's a good time to bring him back. But season 4 came out on a Thursday. The Wednesday before that, we could still use the Ryan Express and DJ BC Raw. And then set 4 drops, and it's like, oh, here's a new version of the same player that you could have used yesterday. But now you have to grind all over to get him. I don't think a lot of people are cool with the idea of grinding for the same card, basically, that they had before, just for a few attribute points better. I think if they're gonna do sets and seasons, they need to go one way or the other. They need to commit to the rotating lineups really, really well, or they just need to axe this sets and seasons model altogether and say, we're either going back to the new content model or we're gonna change it next year to actually make it have a little bit more sense. Sorry, I know this is turning into a rant. Hold on, I just drew a walk with Pudge. Hold on, I gotta focus right here. Trying to hit a bomb with Jazz. Oh, that's down. Jazz is going to drive in at least one, probably only one. Still, though, it keeps the inning going. We got two guys in scoring position. And now it's over. Wow, that was that was only hit 86 off the bat. My voice just cracked. I'm pushing 30. But yeah, sorry this is kind of just turning into a giant rant video. It's just that this Team Affinity grind really kind of opened my eyes to how I truly feel about the mode this year. I've really tried to give it a fair shot. I've really tried to be open-minded with this new content model, because I did say at the beginning of the year, I do appreciate that they are trying something new. Even if it fails, I like that they are willing to say, hey, we're not going to stick to what works. They could have easily released another version of MLB 22 or 21 and, you know, had the same content model, and it probably would have done fine. I at least appreciate them for trying something new and trying to freshen the game up, even if they had that possibility of failing. Oh man, Nolan Ryan's fastball up against this guy is working really well. Yeah, I really just don't feel like the game has truly found its best footing yet this year. And quite frankly, we're in season 4. I struggle to believe the game is going to drastically change in season 5 and 6. Yeah, I don't know. I just feel like they haven't really listened to the feedback in enough of a way to really make a major change to the game that people would be willing to accept. Yes, they added some collections to Team Affinity over the last 2 seasons. People were getting frustrated by only grinding for 97 overall cards the entire time. Nice play, George. They've done little things like that, sure, but they made the pack in the Battle Royale program non-sellable. They did the same thing with ranked season rewards. They're limiting the ways you can make stubs. And I still think this game is the most no money spent friendly out of any of the sports ultimate team game type of modes out there. But man, they've made some really questionable changes to kind of go away from that, with the game basically feeling like grind 97 this year and buy 99. So I really don't know what to expect for MLB The Show going forward. I don't know if they're gonna change the content model in MLB 24, if they're gonna double down on sets and seasons, if they're gonna go back to the way it was in MLB 22. I really have no idea, and I'm really curious to see, because I hope they do take the feedback that the community has and tries to implement it, whether they go with the same content model or change it. But yeah, I'm just gonna end my rant here, because I could probably just keep going for the rest of this video, and I don't want the entire video to be about that. Sorry that this has turned into what it is, but Feel free to let me know in the comments what you think about this. How do you feel about sets and seasons this year? Are you on the same page as me? Do you actually really like it? Because I know there are a lot of people out there that do like it. Let me know in the comments. I'm curious what you guys have to say. It's been a weird year, and there's going to be a lot of differing opinions. Sound off down there. All right. Now that that's out of the way, let's just go ahead and pitch. Nolan's pitched pretty well so far. He has allowed a couple bits of hard contact, but overall, it's been pretty solid. I'm going to go high and in with the heat on Mike Cameron. Oh, this guy's going to be mad when he sees the reaction that Tim Salmon just got in left field. I'm going to go sinker away 2-2. Oh, dude, that late sharp movement on that sinker is nasty. Okay. We've got two outs. Come on. Oh, that was my worst pitch I've thrown with Nolan. He's going to get one. Come on, Nolan. We got to get out of this inning. Oh, that's going to get down. Tim Salmon is not getting there. We got a tie ball game, man. That's a good swing on the fastball. I can't lie. He has made the adjustment and is hitting the ball better. There we go. Now we're out of it. We've basically got a brand new ball game starting in the sixth inning now. Throw that again. Oh, do it again. Jump for the ball. Miss it. Come on, man. What am I doing? Joey Votto had the home run, and every at-bat since has been awful. Pudge, step up. Drive this free base runner in. Come on. Oh, come on, dude. How do I swing through that? Come on, Nolan. I need a zero from you. That last inning was rough. We got to bounce back. Kinsler, please. Nice. I am leaving way too many changeups just over the plate. I am not locating that pitch whatsoever anymore. All right, it may be time to get the bullpen going. Like I said, this guy made the adjustment. Good for him. Ooh, run on Charlie Blackman's arm. I dare you. The most feared arm in right field. Yeah, this is it for Nolan Ryan. What does he have coming up next? Jackie? I'll let him go for Jackie. I think there's a lefty on deck. If Jackie gets on, then it's bullpen. All right, Nolan made it through six. Get the offense going, though, man. I haven't scored since Jazz double down the line. Okay, Jazz, there we go. The only pitch that I'm having trouble with from Roy Halladay is the cutter. I'm feeling pretty good on the sinker. I'm feeling pretty good on the splitter. It's the cutter away to righties that's kind of screwing me up. Dude, I can't hit that cutter. I don't know what it is. But he's going to a lefty now, though, so that actually kind of works out for me. Should I take out George Brett and go to Justin Turner right here? I think I should, honestly. This is a long at-bat for Turner. This is like 10 pitches. Yo, that was a stupid at-bat. I can't lie. I got bailed so many times, and I will be the first one to admit it. All right, new pitcher. Let's go Jose Alvarado. This card's a 95, but don't forget, I got that Tom Henke captain boost on that makes all of these cards pretty good attribute-wise. Oh, Tim Salmon home run robbery is going to be chills right here. Oh, my God. I said that as a joke. I didn't think he was actually going to do it. Let's go, Timmy. Yep, got him to swing at. Pitch out of the zone. Oh, man, he just wanted to swing in that two-strike count. On to the eighth. Come on, let's get the lead right here. Ooh. Ah, why was I not expecting that? I don't think that's leaving. It's not a good enough swing. Yep. Oh, that's tough. Timmy. Save me again. Damn it, dude. That was a good pitch. Oh, it's time for Edwin Diaz. Ooh, 94 on the slider. That was sick. Double play. Get it started, Crawford. Come on. It's a lot of speed. Ah! All right. On to the ninth. We got a tie game. Oh, is that actually gone? Pudge got it on the early swing. We got the lead. Attaboy, Pudge. Hey, need more here. Look at Jazz, bro, getting his third hit of the day. There it is. There it is. Chuck Nasty finally did something. He was 0 for 4 up until this point. Huge two-out home run for some big insurance runs. I'm going to go to Brad Hand. He has two lefties due up this inning, but he's probably going to pinch hit for both of them, so this is going to turn out to be an awful decision by me. Tim Salmon is having the game of his life in left field. Try to go really in with the slider. Popped him up. One out to go. Another pop-up. Pudge is there. And we're going to get the victory in Nolan Ryan's debut. Had to fight for that one, man. Charlie Blackman gets player of the game, although I might give it to Pudge for getting the actual go-ahead home run. Plus, he was 2 for 3. Chuck Nasty was 1 for 5. Shout out to Brad Hand for coming in and closing the door. And once again, sorry a giant portion of that video turned into just me ranting about the game. Hopefully it all made sense. Hopefully it was all easy to follow. And hopefully it didn't take you out of the video too much. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you in the next one.